Hi, I'm Dan Wagand, a meteorologist for the National Weather Service in Medford, Oregon. Do Southern Oregon and Northern California deserve to have a rainy reputation? I'm going to attempt to help you answer that question yourself. To start off, I'm going to take it for granted that our region does have a reputation for rainy weather. My first inkling is that this comic was created by an Oregonian who had spent one too many days in a row stuck in the house on a rainy day. But I believe it sums up the opinion of the average American regarding what a typical day is like for every resident of Oregon. So, how does one define rainy? The simplest and most obvious definition would be to consider a rainy place to be one that receives a lot of rain. From this map of the average annual precipitation in the 48 contiguous states, it is apparent that the coastal and Cascade Mountain ranges from Northern California to Washington fit the bill. One can also see the effect of the rugged topography of the West. There is a wide range of values from extremely wet to extremely dry across the region. Meanwhile, the eastern half of the country is more uniformly moderately wet. Let's zoom in and take a closer look at Southern Oregon. This map does differ slightly from the previous one in that it covers the period from 1961 to 1990 rather than 1981 to 2010. But it will still serve our purpose. The coast and coast range do receive a high amount of precipitation in an average year, in excess of 60 inches. There are also values exceeding 60 inches in the Cascades. But valley locations are almost all at less than 40 inches, including less than 20 inches in both the Medford area and the valleys of South Central Oregon. The map for Northern California tells a similar story, with copious precipitation amounts typical near the coast, especially from Del Norte County into the mountainous far western portion of Siskiyou County. Meantime, the Shasta Valley and the valleys east of the Cascades typically receive less than 15 inches of precipitation per year. Here is a smattering of average values for Coos, Jackson, and Klamath counties in Southern Oregon, as listed at the far right under the column labeled Annual. The data reveals that the coast and mountains are wettest, but also that far less precipitation tends to fall during the summer and early fall than during the remainder of the year. Which leads to another thought. Perhaps there is more to determining whether a location is rainy than how much precipitation falls. How about we also consider how often a measurable rain occurs? Over the course of a year, the eastern half of the country typically receives measurable precipitation once every 3 to 4 days. This is similar to the frequency in southwest Oregon and northwest California, but precipitation is less frequent in the Shasta Valley and in the area east of the Cascades. Here's a look at the precipitation frequency for a few selected locations in southern Oregon. Precipitation occurs at North Bend more than 1.5 times more frequently than at Medford or Klamath Falls. Lastly, let's consider what time of the year precipitation is more or less frequent. The frequency of precipitation in the eastern half of the country shows little seasonal variation. Meantime, precipitation in the northwest is much more frequent from January to March and from October to December than during the other 6 months of the year. The figures on the left-hand side show the average yearly frequency of precipitation, the frequency during the summer months of June through August, and the frequency during the winter months of November through January. Sure enough, rainy days are rare in the summer, and even when it does rain in the summer, it usually occurs in the fleeting form of thunderstorms. So, do Southern Oregon and Northern California deserve to have a reputation for wet weather? A simple answer is elusive. It depends on where you are and what time of the year it is. In general, in the winter, yes, in the summer, no, and during the spring and fall, maybe.